The input section of a mixing console is made up of channel strips, each one for a separate input source. And even though these can look completely different on analog and digital, the signal chain is pretty much the same on all consoles. First comes the preamp section, then the EQ section, followed by the pan, mute, and then the fader section. Now there is a lot here, so we'll cover this in two videos. First, the preamp section here, and then the rest of the channel strip next. In this video, we look at the preamp section, which includes pad, phantom power, and polarity options. It also has the high pass filter setting, which helps us keep a mix clean, as well as the insert, which lets us use tools like gates and compressors. The mixing console takes inputs from microphones, DIs, and other line level sources, each of which gets its own channel strip. So we can think of each channel as the control for one input. And as I mentioned, the signal chain is pretty much the same for both analog and digital, even though you can adjust the order on some advanced digital mixing consoles. Now, when we connect an input source to the console, the very first thing the signal hits is the microphone preamp, or mic pre. This is controlled by the gain knob, and properly setting the gain is the very first step to getting a solid mix. Really, the gain knob is the most important knob on the console. Since this is the first thing in the signal chain of the console, it affects everything else that comes after it. So we do take a look at some tips for setting the gain in the next video. The preamp also has a pad button, which cuts the signal by a fixed amount. This comes in handy when the input signal is so hot that it's clipping the mic pre, even when the gain is all the way down. The pad button then brings this down by something like 20 or 30 dB, which is hopefully a more usable signal. Most consoles also have a polarity switch in the preamp section, which is important for professional audio engineers, but a little beyond the scope of this course. We also have a phantom power button, which sends current through the mic cable to power condenser mics and active DIs. And even though it's technically an EQ, the high pass filter, or HPF, is also found in the preamp section. This lets the high frequencies pass while cutting the low frequencies. High pass filters are used pretty heavily by most live sound engineers, and they are really helpful for getting clean sounds on cymbals, guitars, and definitely also voice, by keeping unnecessary low frequencies out of the mix. Some small analog consoles just do a fixed cut around 100 Hz or 80 Hz, but on professional consoles, you can adjust this, and I even sometimes high-pass vocal mics up to like 160 or even 180 Hz, depending on the situation and what sounds best for that singer's voice. Then finally, at the end of the preamp section is the insert, which is where we have our gates and compressors. Analog consoles don't have these built in, so you have to physically connect outboard gear, but on digital consoles, gates and compressors are built into every channel, and we talk about this more later. I also show you some audio examples so you can hear what these actually sound like. But something that is important to note here, the insert is in between the preamp section and the rest of the channel strip, so while it comes after the preamp, which includes the high pass filter, it comes before the EQ, fader, and aux sends, both pre and post. Like I mentioned, this can be changed on some advanced digital consoles, but in audio, it's always a good idea to have a clear picture of the signal chain. In this video, we took an overview of the preamp section, including gain, pad, polarity, phantom power, high pass filter, and inserts. In the next video, we go through the rest of the channel strip.